The alchemy of wealth from air will bring a second blight upon mankind. This fog of death will cloak the land, and those men who are not prepared will succumb to its foul clutches. For God shows no mercy on those who heed not his words. Thus will the end come, and the world, made unworthy in his eyes, will be purified by black angels so that he may begin anew.
Batteries. would say it's only a nightmare, but isn't everything these days? It's a good thing I found you when I did. Welcome to the safe house. My friends call me the Prepper. You know why? Because I'm always prepared. You might not believe it, but I knew this was coming a long time ago. Now, see that device on the workbench with the screen? Pick it up. That myself. I call it the Prepper Pad. It's a smart map with radar. It's a smart map with radar and a connection back to me, so I can watch over you. And you'll need it. Better sort the lights out. There's a generator in the toilet. See the green light on your smart map? The last person I tried to help went outside without the pad, and look how that ended. But there is something else you can use. That backpack is a BOB, bug out bag, see? You need it and what's inside. Now might be a good time to try out your radar. Go on, pick up the cricket bat. Don't be squeamish. Think of it as an unspoken agreement between survivors. Because if you got infected, would you want someone to do the same for you? Good going. A nasty business, but it's got to be done. Now, check that bulb. As I recall, there's a pistol and ammo you're definitely going to need. Good work. You've got to keep this place clean if you want to survive. More than 20 hours awake, and your decision-making goes to pieces. Don't neglect your sleep. Head back to the main room and take another look at the monitors. They're hooked into CCTV cameras all over London. This one's from a supermarket near you. But the more eyes you have, the better. There's more cameras at that location, so I'll walk you through hacking them. People think CCTV cameras are secure, hardwired to police HQ. But they're wrong. I was a Royal Signals boy in the army. I can teach you a thing or two about secure comms. Time for your first field trip. Fix themselves, and you need to do a little shopping. Give me a sec, I'll get those shutters up for you. to get out. There's bound to be one somewhere at that station. Use your pad's environmental scanner to search the area. Perimeter looks calm, for now. Now, use your pad to scan the area and see what you can loot. Never look a gift horse in the mouth. Thank you. That's the one. This safe house is my handiwork. A long time ago, I teamed up with a bunch of no-hopers called the Ravens of D. I helped them fortify places like this, because we knew this was coming. John Dee predicted the plague and the Great Fire of London that stopped it. And he saw plague victims in his own lifetime. Even tried to find a cure, the panacea. But it's a myth. You can see as well as anyone. There's no cure for this. I'll get that for you. I've locked the place down for your safety. Okay, you're free to come and go now. Scan every CCTV junction box you locate so I can hack it and bring those cameras back online. Excellent. Your smart map's been updated. Without a good map, you're a goner out there. Throwing flares. Now they could come in handy. Bright lights to distract the dimwits. a manhole nearby that's your quickest way back to the safe house. Have a gander. Sometimes retreat is your best option. Good work, soldier. Triangulating. It's inside the supermarket. Be careful. Use your radar. You have to ping areas manually if you want to know what's lurking in your blind spots. Thank you. This is where it all started, and this is where it'll end. I promise you. Protect the safe house. Your survival depends on it.
Dear John, I'm sorry, but I just don't think we're going to agree on this point of interpretation. You seem dead set on a scorched earth reading of the BP, whereas I, and Ron, and many of the others, see it more as a warning that we need to help people, not stand by and watch as it happens. I know you're angry with me and Ron for arguing with you at the last meeting, but I hope you can see that we're just advocating a better safe than sorry approach. It's like global warming. If we're wrong, well, at least we tried to make the world a better place, and no harm done. But if we're right, and we don't act quickly, we're putting the whole planet in danger. I wish you could see that. We're not trying to shut you out or shout you down like you suggested. I know you said those things in the heat of the moment, but even if you didn't mean them, they hurt. Your experience is invaluable to us. That's why I was asked to recruit you in the first place. But we're not children, and we do understand your point of view, we just disagree. The Council has asked me to suggest you take some time off from the meetings, because they don't feel you're being productive right now. I'm not going to do that because I still love you, and know how much being excluded from the Council would frustrate you. But I agree this fatalist agenda isn't productive. I'm about to leave for Clermont-Ferrand to see what I can dig up in their library about the Physici, as discussed at the last meeting. But I'll be back in time for bonfire night. So I'll call you, and we can go up to Ali Pali for the display. It's been too long since we spent an evening together. And I'm sorry about that. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.